Hello again. I promised that I was going to show you my other dry aquarium or candle lantern that I altered. This was the first one I did. I have done three of them one of them I was not able to do a video on it. It was a custom-made order, so I no longer have it. But this one I did with the Graphic 45 paper, and I fuzzy cut some of the images and added it to it. Let me go up close so that you can see. I added some artificial plants or plastic plants and coral, real seashells, gears, charms, pearls. I mean, just about anything I was able to get my hands on, and that would match, you know, that would work here. I did not put, I'm not sure whether I put some netting, fish netting. Yes, I did. You just can't barely see it, but right there. It's hidden behind a lot of other stuff. But anyway, here's a close-up look to it. And there's the image of the mermaid. I did like a three-dimensional on this one. I then cut out the corners and added some little tiny seashells that you can find either at Michael's or Hobby Lobby, to, you know, to do a frame of it somewhat. Now, here, this had one in the middle, but I figured let me cut it off so that it won't obstruct the image of the mermaid. I went ahead and added like this ornament on the top. This crown is from Hobby Lobby, and then just added everything else. This is made out of wood, which I found in Michael's. I painted it the color of the lamp and just added everything else, as you can see. Let me turn it around so you could see the back. Right here is the battery pack. You could see the battery pack on this one. Okay, I turned it. This is the back. As you can see, the artificial coral or the plastic coral. Now, behind that seashell is the battery pack, so that, you know, you can change the battery or turn it on because it does have lights. I did add lights to it, like the other one. And here's the seahorse. Now, this here, also I added some ornament up here so it'll look complete. And there's the side again. Here's the fish netting, like so. Now it opens up. This one opens from the top. I put my hand through here and find the battery pack behind the seashell in order for me to turn it on. Wait, let me show you. There you go. And this is what it looks like when it's lit. And let me see if I can darken the room a little bit. Hold on a second. This is daylight. Here's the lighting. So you can see the little lights. These little lights are garlands, those little tiny lights that you can find in Ross and Marshall's. You can find them in Michael's and Hobby Lobby too, but they're more expensive. But if you go to Ross, Michael's, or TJ Maxx, you'll find them for $3 or $4. And they usually have 25 to 40 lights. But it works. I enjoyed doing it. I've done three already. This one was my first one, which I sold to someone, and I'm going to be taking it to her. It's a local person, a person locally. And then the other one, the big one, the greenhouse one, which is the video, is in my YouTube, is also, that's going to be mine. That one, I'm going to keep that one for my decor. But, well, I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope this inspired you to do your own. It's fun, and this theme and this Graphic 45 paper is awesome for this. I will be doing another one, hopefully, of a steampunk theme also, but not nautical. I'm actually collecting some stuff. If anyone has ideas of where I can find neat stuff for it that I can buy, order, what have you, please let me know. Send me an email or leave it in the comments on YouTube. I would really appreciate it because I have to collect some of the stuff in order to start it. But thanks so much for visiting. Hope you visit again soon. I will be adding some more stuff eventually. So keep an eye on my channel. And happy creating. Bye-bye.